Hi everyone, this is Balázs from RacingBrick. Last year I made a series of videos where I tested different gadgets like 3D printers, laser engravers and other stuff to see how useful they can be in the LEGO world. This was a lot of fun and I learned a lot, but the videos themselves weren't that popular on the channel, so this will be the last one from this series, at least for a while. Maybe I will make videos about these machines on my other channel, which you can find linked in the top right corner. 2024 is definitely the year of space for LEGO. We could already see a whole range of sets from Technic, City, Creator 3-in-1, even Friends and Duplo join the party. We don't know yet if we can expect anything exciting in the Icons team, for example, but I've decided to take a set that was released 3 years ago and do something fun with it. I'm sure you remember the NASA Space Shuttle Discovery. It's a great model with tons of detail and interesting building techniques, looks cool on the shelf, but is missing some core components. Yes, I'm talking about the external fuel tank and the solid rocket boosters. There are some great custom builds on Rebrickable, but when you look at the piece count and the sheer size, you quickly understand why LEGO didn't release these as an official set. I didn't feel like collecting all those pieces, so I looked for an alternative solution. Luckily, Geekbuying reached out to me and offered a fairly new printer to use in my videos, the Anycubic Kobra 2 Max. A massive printer for a huge project, I just needed the right model for it. And it does exist, you can find a matching 3D printable model for the LEGO Discovery on Cult3D by GeckoBricks. This is not an ad for this model, I bought the files and instructions, let's see what the end result looks like. But first we had to assemble the printer. It arrived in a massive cardboard box, and thankfully it didn't require a lot of assembly. It took about 30 minutes and it definitely helps if it's not your first 3D printer. This is the obligatory moment to remove the foil from the touchscreen, and we are ready to switch it on. We had to bring the device into the workshop as it takes up a lot of space. The print volume is a massive 42x42x50cm, it's difficult to find a suitable place for it. Access to the touchscreen isn't the most convenient for me here, but I could only fit the printer sideways. The calibration and setup process is pretty straightforward, but there are a few odd moments, like extruding a big pile of filament and then smashing it with the bed. Here it is, I don't know why that was necessary. The resonance compensation test is pretty funny if you've never seen anything like it. First comes the printhead, and then the whole bed starts to vibrate with increasing frequency, you can really feel it. Then comes the standard benchy print test, which went pretty quickly, and the result looks good too. Time to start the actual project. I have a long list of models to print, this certainly won't be quick, and there are a few big parts. The Kobra 2 Max did a pretty good job, but there are a few things that bother me. First, the printer is advertised as having a speed of 500 mm/s, but the Cura profile you can install from the official instructions only says the speed to 160 mm/s, which is quite a difference. I looked it up online and most people recommend a maximum speed of 250, that's pretty fast, but certainly not 500. It's also a lot louder than my FL-SOM V400, I can't hear that one upstairs, but I know exactly when this one finishes the job without taking a look. I asked the designer about the filament used for the fuel tank. He advised me to use the Seal Copper PLA from Overture. I bought this one from Sanlu instead as the other one was not available here. At first glance it seems similar, but I think the end result is much shinier than in his photos. So here are all the parts, it took me a few days to print everything. Let's start with the SRB, because that seemed to be the most straightforward. It has 4 parts, pretty simple, and here it is. This thing is going to be massive. The bottom of the fuel tank is made up of 2 halves, which can be put into position with small pieces of filament, that is a clever trick. The assembly of the fuel tank is similar to the boosters. I won't show all the details of the process, but you can see a few highlights here. There are a lot of small rings and circlips to fit to the SRBs, it really takes a while. Then comes the assembly of the main units, it's advisable to use some glue, you will see why later. The wheels of the space shuttle need to be removed, so it can be attached to the fuel tank. As it's rolling around, I wanted to check if I could put the assembly on the stand and then attach the space shuttle. This is how you add the extension to the original stand, but without the weight of the shuttle, it won't stay here. Okay, let's try it on the table. It's certainly not the easiest task, but I managed to put the whole thing on the stand, and here is the end result. I have to say that it looks much more impressive than the space shuttle alone. A pure LEGO build at this size would be super expensive, but would look certainly fantastic. Yes, the fuel tank is shiny, this is the pre-flight polished version. Despite its size and weight, the original stand can support everything with the extended base, of course. Now let's see if I can put everything on the vertical stand. Oh, okay, nope. I should have used a stronger glue for the support parts.
A few moments later.
Okay folks, I didn't film the restoration, but here's the assembly on the vertical stand. It's mainly standing on the boosters, but there are also slots supporting the wings. That's a pretty impressive position. Let's put it next to the leaper crane so you can get an idea of the full size. I might put it here for a while, although I think the other stand is a better long-term solution. So, I think this was a cool project with a very impressive end result. The Anycubic Kobra 2 Max did its job without any particular problems. The whole printer feels a bit unfinished though, especially when it comes to the software. Wi-Fi only works via cloud service, camera support was only added like a week ago with the latest firmware, and there are a lot of minor annoyances. If you absolutely need a large print volume, it could be a good choice, but otherwise I would go for the FLSUM V400. As for the Molo, it's incredible what you get for just a few bucks. The files are detailed and accurate, the instructions are easy to follow, there are a few minor errors, but nothing serious. If you have a 3D printer and want to improve the look of your LEGO Space Shuttle by like 1000%, it's highly recommended. Let me know in the comments how you like the end result. If you would add 3D printed accessories to your LEGO sets, let's talk about it in the comments section. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe with notifications, as more exciting LEGO videos are coming soon. See you next time, bye bye!